ओके गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस पोईम फायर एंड एस, आई एम गोइंग टू लिटिल बिट गिव इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द बायोग्राफी ऑफ रॉबर्ट ली फ्रॉस्ट. नाउ दिस इज द पिक्चर ऑफ रॉबर्ट ली फ्रॉस्ट, हु इज द पोइट ऑफ दिस पोईम. रॉबर्ट ली फ्रॉस्ट बॉर्न इन मार्च 26, 1874 एंड डाइड इन जनवरी 29, 1963 वॉज एन अमेरिकन पोइट. His work was initially published in England and before it was published in USA, United States. Known for his realistic depictions of rural life and his command of American colloquial speech, Frost frequently wrote about settings from rural life in New England. In the early 20th century, using them to examine complex social and philosophical themes. Now let's start Fire and Ice, that is in your syllabus. Some say the world will end in fire and some say in ice. From what I have tasted of desire, now here some means people and end means finish and tasted means experienced and desire wish. The poet talks about two different beliefs regarding end of the world. In these two lines he says that he is in the favor of those who say this world will end in fire, and he has seen the effect and result of uncontrolled and unbending desires. He finds the human desires same as a fire in its nature. I hold with those who favor a fire, but if it had to perish twice. Now here hold means agree and favor means support, and perish means die, and twice means you know very well two times. I think I know enough of hate I to say that for destruction ice is also great and would suffix. Now here destruction means ruin and suffix means sufficient. On the other hand, the second belief of the poet wants to tell us that the ice is sufficient for destroying this world. And the poet compares the nature of ice with hatred. As ice can make a part of body numb with its prolonged contact, like hatred can also give numbness to our mind and thoughts and make us sensitive and cruel. Now this is a brief explanation of this poem, and now come to the theme of this poem. Also the poet has written a symbolically poem. The poet says that there are mainly two opinions about the end of this world, one by fire and another by ice. The symbols fire and ice has been used for human emotions like desires and hatred respectively. As fire can spread very fast and cause a great destruction in no time, likewise our desires may also prove destructive if they go out of control. Hatred causes slow destruction like ice, but it is also very harmful. There are many other ideas how the world will end. Robert Frost also points out two destructive forces in this poem also, by the fire and ice. Yes, everything is subjected to an end. The world would come to an end someday. The cause may be the war or natural calamity. It's depend upon that situation. The sun is the main source of energy and it is life of the earth. If the sun gets hot, that it is burst and grew colder and colder, and the life on the earth would come to an end. I hope You people understood this poem very well. Okay, beta. Have a nice day.